Welcome to Office 365 Questions. My name is Elliot Munro. I work for the Ozbizweb Group on the Gold Coast of Australia. We are a Microsoft partner who specialise in cloud services for small to medium businesses. So let's have a look at how we set up Office 365 email on an iPhone. There are two ways to set up Office 365, or two main ways to set up Office 365 email on your iPhone that you might like to use. One of them is straight through the Mail app, which is just down here at the bottom. So this is the standard Apple Mail app. Now I've deleted all my email accounts just for the sake of this demo, but I'm going to show you how to add a new one. So if we go to Settings here, and then we go down to Mail, Contacts, and Calendars, we can click Add Account. And this is going to let us add our Office 365 account. So we click Exchange Account, and then we put in our email address and our password. If you're not sure of your email address and your password, contact your administrator and they'll be able to provide you with that information. Okay, so I've put in my password here, and it's going to go and it's going to verify with the Office 365 servers that my email and password is correct and bring down all those details. If you find that this doesn't work for you and you're the Office 365 administrator, just make sure that the auto discover information is configured correctly on your domain. So this verification takes a little while, and then once it's finished, it's going to let me know that the connection's been successful, and it's going to let me sync the different aspects of my Office 365 Exchange Online connection. So it's going to let me sync my email, my calendar, my contacts, and my reminders and notes. So I'm going to turn on notes here, and I'm going to keep my existing notes on my iPhone. So then we click save, and this will set up the account just like it would any other account on your phone. So once we've added that account, we want to set that as the default account for our mail, contacts, and calendars. And the way to do that is inside the mail, contacts, and calendars section, and we go down to default account. So we tap here, and then we change this to Exchange. That's going to change it to our Office 365 account. And we do the same for contacts and calendars as well. So we change the default account for the contacts here, and lastly, the calendars at the bottom. So that means that every new email contact or appointment that you create is going to be syncing with Office 365 by default. So if I close out of settings now and I go to Mail, my Exchange email is not going to come down straight away because it's going to sync things in the background as well. It should come down in the next few seconds. Now, while that happens, I'm going to show you the other way that we can set up Office 365 on our phones, and that's with the Outlook web app, or the OWA app. Now, I use this because it has some features that the existing app doesn't have. So if we go to the App Store and we search for OWA, and we click on the first result, which is OWA for iPhone, that's going to let us download that. Okay, so that's just downloading in the background. Now, while that downloads, I'll just see where that's going to go. It's going to go here on the right-hand side. I'm going to go back to my email, and we'll see that my email is coming here now. So that is set up that way through the Apple app, and then I'm going to open up this OWA app once it's done. Now, the cool thing about the OWA app is that it lets us do a few things that the existing mail app on the iPhone doesn't do, and one of those things is shared calendars. So you might notice if you're using an Exchange account and someone sends you or shares a calendar with you, you want to be able to access those calendars on your phone, and perhaps it's your boss's calendar and you want to be able to add appointments to their calendar. You can't do that with the usual mail app. That's where this OWA app comes in handy, because it gives you the ability to do that. So if we click continue here and we sign in just the same way on this OWA app, so I'm going to put my details in, then it's going to bring down pretty much exactly the same account, but inside this app. There are a few little things which are different about this app, things like you can't click on phone numbers in emails, which can get quite annoying, and there's a few other little things which you might not like as much as you like the mail app on the iPhone, but I use this for my main email app, and once you get used to it, then you're not going to have any issues. So there's a little setup screen here which gives you some information. This looks just like the apps on Windows mobile devices. So if you're used to a Windows mobile device, this is going to look quite intuitive to you. And then we can go to the inbox. So all the emails that come through on my normal email are coming through on my OWA app as well. Okay, so you can use both apps. And if we open up this little thing down in the bottom left-hand corner here, this gives us access to our calendar as well. So our calendar information is here. This app is going to be running a little bit slowly while it brings down all that information at the start. But once it gets going, you'll find it'll work exactly the same way. If you have shared calendars shared with you, you can access them by clicking this little menu button on the bottom right-hand corner and then going to calendars and it's going to bring up all the other calendars. Since I've got no calendar shared with me right now, I'm only going to see my own calendar. If you have any questions about setting up Office 365 email on your iPhone, you can leave a comment or make an inquiry on our website. Thank you.